operation. The two UH-1 helicopters are now airborne and transporting a recon team to an insertion point in the Central Highlands. Their escorts are two AH-1 TAC helicopters whose mission is to provide fire. Look up and you'll see a Cobra gun team high overhead, consisting of two AH-1 helicopters. One of the Cobras 3-3 will descend to check out the LZ and take a closer look, while Cobra 3-4 remains high in the overhead watch to provide any supporting firepower if needed.
Tell right away that I was bad to the bone. Bad to the bone.
Looks like Cobra 3-3 has taken fire from the enemy. Notice how quickly he gets into position to engage the enemy. And he is being joined by his teammate, Ghost Shot, at Cobra 3-3. Go and escort the recon team in while Cobra 3-4 remains on station to keep the LZ under surveillance and provide any supporting fire if necessary. Cobra 3-4 has just radioed them and said it is determined there are no more Viet Cong prisoners in the vicinity and the landing zone is safe for the insurgents. Ladies and gentlemen, if you'll look to your left, the recon team is inbound in UH-1 helicopters lift 2-1 and lift 2-2. And Cobra 3-3 now leads the Hueys into the landing zone. Let's listen to their radio calls.
Cobra 3-3, go ahead.
Cobra 3-3, we're inbound.
Roger, 2-1, I have you in sight. I'm in hot.
The UH-1 has just demonstrated to you a tactic that was used many times in Vietnam to confuse any enemy in the area of the operation. They just made a false insertion into a different landing zone nearby, and then they will take off and they'll insert the reconnaissance team into their real intended point of insertion. As soon as the second UH-1 touches down, the recon team will depart the aircraft and disappear into the triple canopy jungle. The helicopters you see here today are real combat veteran aircraft that flew hundreds of combat assault missions in Vietnam and being flown by real combat veterans themselves. You're now witnessing combat veteran Army aviators flying actual Vietnam combat aircraft. As the UH-1s clear the LZ, the Cobras will go back in for a final rocket run to suppress enemy activity and provide the reconnaissance team time to disappear without a trace.
Roger 2-1, I'm in hot. Final run.
Nothing is identified with the Vietnam War more than the sound and image of the UE helicopters. An entire generation remembers the UH-1's distinctive sound. The Army employed helicopters to do a variety. In the lead, UH-1, lift 2-1. We have Colonel retired Don Conaway. We have former CW-2 Ron Disney. And the crew chiefs are Gene Newton. And we have George Meeker, an all-Vietnam crew in the first aircraft. In the second UH-1, we have CW-2, former Captain Jack McCormick, and CW-5, and Chris Tenaro from the Florida Army National Guard. And the crew chiefs are Matt Miller, and our senior crew chief, Master Sergeant Art Villarreal, a Vietnam veteran. God bless you, and God bless America.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Sky Soldiers. On the takeoff roll, the beautiful sound. 120,000 horsepower has fired up in the smoke and thunder jet car. Bill Brock at the controls. 6,500 pounds of thrust with the afterburner on. Only weighs 2,300 pounds. It's 26 feet long.